Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP. Today I have a new build to start with, and this is the Abyss Knight build that I called it, because he has the Rain set, which looks like Artorias Cessus armor, and this is why I called it Abyss Knight, because he looks like from the Abyss, and this is the theme of this build, from the Abyss. Because I had the, like I already said, the Fume Knight armor and also the Majestic Greatsword, which is Artorias' sword. I also had the Dark Mask to look it more like an Abyss type of character. I had in this PvP the theme of this weapons of this build were a character who uses the dual wield. The awesome dual wield animation of the Majestic Greatsword dual wield, which is kinda a flip on the floor and then launching into the air and smacking the opponent down. At the beginning I did this with, in the right hand, the Shotel and the Chaos Blade, because I was mainly a quality character and I like to play with the Shotel and the Chaos Blade. But in the end I ended up with using the Drake Blood Greatsword, I think is it, which is a cool weapon. And here I lost the trade. And this guy did welcome, or well, what is it, what the fuck he meant to do it. And yeah, if you didn't know, the Abyss sword, the Majestic Greatsword, needs like 38 strength and 38 dex to dual wield, also 20 faith and 20 int, which is really damn high, and this is still a 150 level build, level 150 build, so I had to change my setup a bit, but it ended up being good. Of course I had a less health and less endurance, but it was really awesome fun to play with this build. Sometimes I also parried barehanded because I wanted to practice the barehanded parries. Yeah. So now let's start with the commentary on the fights. This guy with his buffed up katana. Of course the buffs are still common in PvP, why not? Why shouldn't they? Because if you can get overpowered, why wouldn't you? It's a good logic. Here we trade for the both down epic kill thing. This guy... Yeah, the warped sword. I saw that the warped sword is a common thing in PvP right now, because it has really high damage and it has the scimitar parry, which is a really decent parry timing. And yeah, of course his buffed up sun chaos blade in the offhand, which does also incredible amount of damage. So you see, this build is all about doing as much damage as possible. You saw that dodge. What the fuck? I did the jumping attack and then came back to the floor, to the pancake, and kinda kneeled on the floor, and he threw a knife and it was right above my head. So awesome. Later, in later fights I think, I do like, dodge against lance. So I launched up in the air, he hit his poke with the lance and missed, and then I came back to the pancake, which was just like awesome thing. Also in these fights I tried to finish the opponents off with the launch attack, because it's just so satisfying if you hit the opponent with that, and the damage is also good. No matter what you say, Alex, the damage is good on the kinda launch two-handed two-handed L2 attack, the strong power stance attack. The normal power stance attack, the weak power stance attack is normal double weapon hit swing from left to right and then to from right to left, which you see me using a few times. This guy, the common straight side play while with buffing up this until oblivion, yeah, the common things, you know. And this guy, which has this character name, uses keyboard, which I think, yeah, I used the keyboard too at the beginning of when I started playing Dark Souls 1 and Dark Souls 2, so that's not that special. You can still do everything if you set up right. Yeah, you're not really something amazing if you play with keyboard, but maybe he is, maybe I missed something of his playstyle, straight out R1, R2 spam, but at least I got a pretty damn damaging pancake in here. And yeah, did I say that the Majestic Greatsword has an awesome moveset one-handed also, if you have it in the left hand? Because if you don't know, Artorias was left-handed, and so if you have it in the left hand, it has a special moveset, which would be a spin to win of the one-handed R2, L2 in this case, and the somersault flip if you two-handed and press the R2 here. And yeah, this guy was losing the fight with his great weapon, and of course he wasn't able to lose, and of course he had to pull out his shadow dagger and just get the backstab, because no fun allowed, right? No fun allowed in PvP. Yes, we all know that people play this game to win and not to have fun, because winning in this game is, winning without having fun is of course more important than having fun. Here you didn't see what I did, but he just did his strange spell, which is the staggering spell, which doesn't do much damage, so I just tanked through that shit and did the flip attack, the jumping attack. This guy buffed in the middle of the fight, so I didn't bother attacking him because the fight already started. Chotel hits still through shields, and then back, and boom! Trading with the L2. So, like I said, with this build, trading and hitting the R2 is the most fun thing ever. It's comparable to having fun with the Smelter Hammer, which you may have seen, the Smelter Hammer PvP. So, yeah, you just do incredible damage, launch up in the air, and then you just pancake your opponent with this long wind-up timed attack, which is really cool. This guy kind of did a good job at fighting, I think. Also, if you miss the floor attack like you saw there, right here, and you launch up, you still have a pretty damn good reach to land the smash down attack, because the Majestic Greatsword has incredible reach, like the best reach of all greatswords, I think. Of course, this guy using the meta weapon of the game, which would be the Red Iron Twin Blade. But with this build you don't have much problems against those people, because you see this damage that I did there? Incredible. Incredible! Then he ran away, probably to heal, but yeah, also, oh, there, this, I have to commentate on this thing. This is Cold Phoenix, a German guy, which contacted me and discovered my channel in the first Dark Souls, so in Dark Souls 1 already, but we weren't able to connect right and do a dueling episode together, and there I met him randomly fighting with the malformed skull and then fighting naked. And yeah, the malformed skull would have one-hitted me with the backstab if we were pre-patch, where the backstabs got nerfed. And I'm glad they did get nerfed. Yeah. He does a pretty good job at fighting against me, and of course he was playing with a pretty damn heavy weapon and slow weapon, and yeah, here I kinda get a bit of lag staggering, I think, but still, he messaged me and said that he actually didn't lose much fights with this setup, naked with the malformed skull, and yeah, because the weapon is pretty good, but it has a really fucking low durability. You really don't want to do like long fights against this. And here you saw a good example of how big the reach, the how far around of you the L2 attack of this power stance goes, because he was like rolling to the right of me and still getting caught by it. So yeah, it's pretty damn cool to fight, and it looks awesome. It looks fucking awesome if you just do this flip attack. You really feel like Artorias. This guy did a pretty good job at fighting against me with the Froome Ultra Greatsword, and in the end I ended up, maybe I ended up killing him, you don't know right now. So anyways, I got this thing here. Here, I got him. This is the last fight. This was the last fight. I hope you enjoyed this episode. And thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I already said that shit. I see you all in the next one. Bye bye.